Now it's a time for Leaders of Now, and with me this morning is Cindy Andrews, who is a youth leader involved in youth mentorship of the youth in Tobago.
Yes, that's correct.
All right, so how are you doing this morning, Cindy?
I'm good, how are you?
Yes, doing very, very well. So tell me a little bit about your involvement in youth leadership. How do you lead youth?
Okay, well, currently I'm the president of the Bell Garden Police Youth Club. It's one of the youngest police youth clubs in Tobago. It was launched last year.
Okay.
On December 8th, we'll be celebrating our one-year anniversary, as well as awards ceremony. Yes, that's on Saturday. Unfortunately, because of exams in Trinidad, I would be unable to attend, but I'm sending all the best wishes to my police youth club and special wishes to our leader, WPC Daniel, who has led us for a good year, and I hope she continues to.
Yeah, I don't see why she wouldn't. And, you know, you being one of the youth mentors for the police youth club.
Yes.
You know, I see good things coming out of that. So what are some of the things that you do to mentor youth?
Well, before I left for Trinidad to pursue my studies at the University of the West Indies, I mentored during my final year of CAPE at the Signal Hill Youth Center. I mentored and volunteered tutoring math and English for both primary and secondary students.
And so you tutored?
Yes, I tutored. Okay. Additionally, I did private tutoring in Spanish as well as remedial writing and reading for students in primary school.
Do you speak Spanish? You're fluent in Spanish?
Fluent enough to teach.
Maybe I need some lessons.
Well, basic hola, buenos dias.
Well, yeah, that I know. Hello, good morning.
Yes, good.
All right, and tell me, how many, if you could remember, if you have a general figure of how many youth you would have influenced over the time?
Well, I would have interacted with probably close to 500 youths. The programs that I do are very vast. I am also I was the Eastern Regional Rep for the Trinidad and Tobago Youth Ambassadors for the Tobago chapter.
Right.
I'm now the Tobago Executive Regional Rep for the Trinidad and Tobago Youth Ambassadors as I'm based in Trinidad. As part of that program, we would have done Project STEP, which is the school transitioning and empowerment program, where we go to various primary schools throughout the island and try to bridge the gap between primary school students as they go into secondary schools. We realized that there was a culture shock when they left primary school into secondary school,
right,
and to avoid that damage that is done when they don't understand what is expected of them, and just to help them flesh out any problems that they may have, because a lot of primary school students, they would have had some ideas and misconceptions about what is expected of them in high school. So we wanted to provide that safe environment where persons closer to their age would be able to talk to them about their experiences.
Yeah, also, like, even from my experience transitioning from primary school into secondary school, you know, you still have some of those primary school habits and mentality, and that transition is not always smooth.
Yes, it isn't. Even though that they would have been accustomed to a heavy workload, it intensifies as you go into high school. You know,
right,
have to juggle between 13 to 16 subjects.
Correct.
There's that stricter time regiment, and there are all these opportunities that you want to take, and a lot of students think that they can't grasp them or they can't reach them because they have to focus on their studies. But for me, as someone that would have been the vice captain of my football team at Bishop's High School.
Is there anything you don't do?
I don't sing. Well, I do, but not very well. So I'll leave that to Natasha. Yes, I would advocate for that holistic development, because
right,
that's something that our school would have embedded in us from the motto, to develop well-rounded students.
Right.
So that's something I always encourage young people to do, and I always try to remind them that volunteering is something that they should always try to do.
Yeah, that spirit of volunteerism is really necessary in creating well-rounded and altruistic individuals.
Correct.
For the future, you know, so going from youth into adulthood.
Yes.
What was the other thing I wanted to ask you? Right. Well, you know, you're involved in so many things that are voluntary, and, you know, like, you give so much of yourself. Who is it? Did you have any major influences that, you know, taught you these ways, or is it something that just came to you naturally? Were your parents involved?
Well, I was always encouraged at home to pursue whatever I was passionate about,
right,
and helping people is something I was really passionate about. I grew up with my great-grandmother and grandmother, so my great-grandmother, she's a little rough around the edges, but she will always encourage me, as well as my mom, to be kind to people. And that is something that my dad also instilled in me. From
right,
young, you know, you always have to tell all the neighbors good morning. And from that,
it just developed
into a broader habit of always wanting to help people.
Yes.
So I started volunteering independently at the age of 15. My best friend, Zaria, should have invited me to volunteer at the Healing for Horses camp in Tobago. It's a camp that tries to integrate into society persons who have disabilities, and they use horse therapy.
Horse therapy?
Yes.
Do you understand much about it?
Well, I wasn't there for long, but it was my first volunteering experience, and I understood how impactful it was on the young persons who lived with disabilities to have that environment where they could interact with persons of different communities and have that experience of inclusion. So that was my first volunteering experience. And then from that, from working at the camp, I started volunteering independently at homes throughout Tobago, and then that just became into a bigger project of me now being at the executive head of two organizations.
Wow, you know, I'm really impressed with everything that you're doing and everything you're involved in. I don't even know how you find the time. Yeah. You know, it's really impressive, and that's why you're here being one of our leaders of now.
Yeah.
On this show, we like to showcase our young people who are doing a lot, because many times they say, well, the young people are the future, but for us to prepare for the future, we have to start that work now.
Yes, that's correct.
You know, we can't start the work in the future and expect it to be for the future. It would be like further ahead and delayed.
Yes.
All right? So just before we close off, what's in the future for you?
Well, currently I'm pursuing my Bachelor in Science and Psychology Special at the University of the West Indies. I am in the process of joining more organizations because I just love to do work. We're actually the Trinidad and Tobago Youth Ambassadors in Trinidad. We're having Camp Excel, which runs from the 17th to the 21st of December. So you can check out Trinidad and Tobago Youth Ambassadors page for more information.
All right, well, Cindy, thanks so much for joining us, and you know, just congratulations on all that you're doing. You know, keep at it. You know, you're really making a difference. You know, you may be just one person, but you're really making a difference, and I wish you all the best.
Thank you so much.
All right, thank you, Cindy, and thanks for being here.